Everyone, welcome to round two. We've won the roll, so we're gonna play first. And this hand is fine. We've got Cadets, Mirror Energy, Lightning Helix to clear away, so we're not gonna mulligan. Unfortunately, we do have all of our white sources in our hand, so if we draw Temple Garden, Windswept Heath, it's gonna be sort of awkward. But hey, that's only one card, right? Lead off with Plains afterwards, then tapped Sacred Foundry if we draw a land for a Mirror Entity. And a Wasteland. Scary stuff. Alright, well, I'm all for Time Walks as long as we're getting damage onto the board. So we'll play this guy tapped and then attack with our Goblin Cadets. Teach him who's boss. And black. So we can go ahead and... Ooh, Ranger Views. That's going to be pretty sweet. Hopefully we draw a fourth land at some point before we draw the rest of our one drops. And so we'll go ahead and play our Keldon Marauders. Boom. Take some damage, please. If he plays a guy, then we can Lightning Helix it. And that does not look like it's going to be the case. That is quite daunting. Quite scary. I mean, who plays Wasteland into Goblin Cadets if you're not going to advance your board? Shrine. Well, that's a good card. You can let that uptick. Yeah, that's better than playing Mirror Entity here. Let's see what happens. Oh. I have a feeling our Goblin Cadets is leaving the battlefield. If that happens to be the case, then Mirror Entity is not as strong. I think I'm going to play Shrine. Unfortunately, we're going to have nothing in play, but this Ranger is going to solve that. Shadow Mage Infiltrator. Ugh. That kind of sucks. Take him down to 11. Kind of want this Lightning Helix to point at him. I don't really care about his Finkle. I'll yield to this. And there we go. So I'm just going to play Ranger here. I don't really care if he draws a bunch of cards. If he's dead, doesn't matter how many cards he has in his hand. Hopefully he doesn't have Daze. Alright. You want to use the ability? Yeah, kind of. So we'll go ahead and get Spikeshot Elder and Frenzied Goblin, I think. Can get Jackal Pup, but that gets wrecked by this guy. And I would rather have Spikeshot Elder for Mirror Entity. Mirror Energy for 2. Maybe that's a little bit too cute. Maybe we just, yeah. If the Mirror Energy dies, then having Spike Shot Elder is going to be great. So we'll get around those guys. Look at that. So awesome. And let's see if Mr. Finkel's going over to say hello. He is, so we're going to block with our face. And we can let him draw a card. It's not that bad. Let's see what he can do for 4 mana. This is where things get scary. Alright, so it's our turn. He's doing nothing. Ooh, Curse Scroll. That's going to be awesome, too. So let's go ahead and smash him and see what happens. May I like to attack, please? I would like to attack, if that's possible. Do you have some sort of removal spell? Probably just sit on the shrine for a little bit. Let's see. Got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So if this hits him, it's gonna be pretty good for us. Snapcaster Mage, huh? Hmm. That's unfortunate. For Doomblade. Ugh. Yeah. I think we just let him have that here. And work him with the shrine, I think. We'll just go play that, play that. Helix him. And then one Curse Scroll activation should be good. Like, I don't actually care if he kills all of these guys at this point. It is kind of annoying. You could just play Curse Scroll and then pass. That ends up being taking a little bit of time though. Play Helix, and yeah, I'm just gonna get these guys into play. I wanna wrap this guy up, and yeah, it's just gonna be better. Let's just pass the turn. He's obviously gonna Doomblade or Spike Shot Elder. I'm fine with that, I don't care. Just wanna get more damage into play. And we'll let that happen. So this is gonna be up to 5 when we Helix on the OT. Yep, draw your card. I don't care about that. Hopefully he doesn't run away with this. I think between, it's pretty hard for to deal with this. I mean, there's stuff like balance, I mean, Into the Royal, Venter, Cryptic Command, Upheaval. And he goes to play an island. And he's just passing the turn. Well, I'm gonna face him, I think. And see what he does with that. If he gets countered, that kind of sucks. But if he has a counter, he has a counter. Whatever. Got Cursed Scroll, so I really want to just empty my hand out. Well, let's see what he's got. It looks like to be a Condescend. Okay. Well, those are going on top. So, we might be in a little bit of trouble. Let's go ahead and play our Bloodstainmire. Crack at him for 1. And see what he does. Yeah, I don't really want to make it so he can't block. Now we can play either Mirror Entity or Curse Scroll, or both. I think at this point, I'd rather just get everything into play. Play Mirror Entity. Or, let's see, Curse Scroll, that'll be pretty much lethal. I think I'm actually just going to play Curse Scroll. And now the ball's in his court, I suppose. 2 mana, 3 mana makes a Thirst for Knowledge. If I had to guess, yes. Alright, so let's set a stop and see what he discards. He might want to do something. Discards Mox Diamond? Ugh, whatever. That's fine, I don't care about that. Alright, so he goes to play Island. Going to combat, attacking again. Pretty bold for you, mister. Now, if he has something like Frost Titan, I'm going to want to just let him do that and then lock down or use the shrine when he has a. before it gets locked down. We'll have to wait and see what he does. Might not be Frost Titan, could be some other stuff, but this guy looks like he was the guy, one of the guys to our left. He's got Mox Diamond, we saw all that, we saw the Thirst. Let's see, we did not see Snapcaster Mage. We did see Upheaval, so there is that to think about. We just shrine him if that's the case. Replay our Frenzied Goblin. And after some thinking, he plays a Serum Visions. Let us see where those cards go. He must have just drawn that off of Shadow Mage Infiltrator, otherwise he would have played that pre-combat. Unless he had a 6-drop that he was considering playing until he drew something different. But I would guess that this is a card that he drew off of Shadow Mage. And top. Ugh. So he's going to EOT, so I think we're just going to go ahead and To him. Uh-oh. Looks like a Venser, maybe. Cryptic command. Yeah, that's not going to work out too well for us. All right. That kind of sucks. So we're just going to name Shrine of Burning Rage. See what happens. Shrine of Burning Rage. Nope. And that's balls. So I guess we'll just go ahead and play everything out. Let's attack him. Play this mirror entity. And play the shrine. Well, that turn certainly did not go well. But we do have Mirror Entity now, so we'll have to see. Hopefully he doesn't have too much of a removal. We're just gonna bide our time here. We'll draw as many cards as he wants. And Slaughter Pact. We'll let that resolve. And hopefully this is not Frost Titan. There's Frost Titan. Well, we can at least attack past that with our Frenzied Goblin. So let's see, this, we should crack this on our upkeep, I suppose. So we don't want to draw lands at this point. Just auto yield to this. And Mogmoor Marshal, not the worst. So let's see, whenever Frost Titan becomes a target of a spell or an ability that kind of blah blah blah, unless it pays two, well, that's fine. So we'll go ahead and smash face. Boom. Pay all of the mana. So let's go ahead and pay two to cancel that. And then tap, make it so you can't block. Look at that. Getting through damage like nothing. And then we'll go ahead and trigger our shrine and ship the turn. He's got Slaughter Pack to pay for. He wants to attack. He can lock down this guy. But then we have the Curse Scroll active again. So, and we can always block with a War Marshal so we don't have to pay Echo. So it's not that bad. Alright, so we paid for Slaughter Pact. It's a little bit easier online. I've actually forgotten to pay for it in real life. It's quite surprising, as it turns out. It's like, oh look, I lose the game. Well, that sucks. So he's got a few decisions to make. He's probably going to be attacking with Shadow Mage Infiltrator. And if he attacks with Shadow Mage Infiltrator, he'll attack with Frost Titan. But we've got a few problematic cards on our side of the board. And a way to make it so that any creatures that he plays can't block. So he's actually in a little bit of a quandary, I think. And he's going directly to combat, so let's see. Alright. My guess is that he's locking down Shrine now, because it's going to be more damage than Curse Scroll. And this is where we block with War Marshal. Yes. So we're going to go ahead and block faster than humanly possible. Speed of Light. So he's up to 8 cards. And let's see what nasty stuff he can throw at us now. We've got at least 2 damage on the table. So let's hope that Curse Scroll stays here for a while. And Jace. It's not bad. Plus 1, so that gets rid of our tokens. So at this point we're in a little bit of trouble. Ooh, Kelvin Champion. That's not bad. So we can kill Jace this way. Or we can just do a bunch to him. If we kill Jace, then that unlocks our Frenzied Goblin. So I think I'm actually just going to go to the dome with him. Hot stuff coming through. And now we can just keep on blocking Frost Titan, so I like this a little bit better. So we'll do three to him. Shrine of Burning Rage is now lethal. Do you want to redirect them to Jace? Nope. Then we'll attack him. So Frost Titan has to lock down Shrine of Burning Rage for the rest of the game. We can pay Echo. And if we spike a land, then we can Curse Scroll. Unfortunately, not on that turn, though. We can use Frenzied Goblin, though. So, assuming all of this stays in play. Just have to wait and see. Trinket Mage. Let's see what else he has besides Mox Diamond. And Search for Nothing. Okay. So it's just Mox Diamond there. Sadly, a Grey Ogre is going to be good enough. Jace is probably going to have to keep on plus one-ing just because we got a bunch of stuff. Yep, and he's going to plus one again. Frost Titan has to attack to keep down Shrine. So let's see what else he plays. Ponder. I think if he actually attacks with Shadow Mage Infiltrator, he's going to be in pretty deep trouble, but I think I'm just going to go in with Curse Scroll trying to get the win out of this game. He chose to shuffle his deck. Alright. So at this point, Frost Titan's going to be attacking us. I would assume that Shadow Mage is probably not going to, because he wants to be able to moat this guy somehow. And if we attack the Frenzied Goblin also so that he can't block with that, he's going to have to have put something else in play or have a removal spell and attack me with everything. So that's kind of bold. Let's see what he plays post-combat. So we're going to go ahead and keep on blocking there. These goblin tokens are being put to good use. All right, after a little bit of stumbling, I finally decided to block with the goblin token. And Shadow Mage Infiltrator is going to get through for yet another card. And that Jace was pretty good. Okay. Let's go ahead and see what else is going on. Oh my, what is this? Is this an Ink Eyes? That's an Ink Eyes. So he's probably getting maybe Spike Shot Elder. Maybe Mirror Entity. Mog War Marshal. Okay, I think I'm not going to bother paying Echo on this. Yeah, so we'll go ahead and uptick our shrine yet again. And don't feel like paying Echo, because I really want to draw a burn spell here. Gargan Dragonlord, good enough. So let's go ahead and do three to him. Name Kargan Dragonlord, play it, level it up one. Kargan Dragonlord. Boom. Do you want to direct the damage to Jace? No. You can be at one. And we'll go ahead and play that and level it up. All right, let's see. Looks like he's paying Echo. That's scary. Night Veil Specter. Well, that's the only spell that gets him out of this situation. Now he has to find a solution for Curse Scroll. And let's see. What is he going to do? There's Jace Beldren. Alright. He's keeping young Jace. All of our guys are active. Each player draws a card. Zozu the Punisher. So we're going to go ahead and scroll him in upkeep. Then play Zozu. So he won't be able to play a land. He'll have to be attacking with Frost Titan to lock down one of these guys. And he's attacking with his Rat Ninja. Probably be getting a Mirror Entity. So this is kind of interesting. Okay, locking down Shrine again. So we're just going to go ahead and... I think we're actually going to block with both here. Because I don't want to give him a Keldon Champion and hope he has Burn. Because if he has Burn, he can get Keldon Champion and then Domas. So I think what I'm going to do is just Baleful Strix. Alright. And what does he have now? Night Vale Spectre. So, I think we'll just go ahead and scroll him in upkeep. Ooh, crazy. Zozu. Z-O. Okay. Zozu the Punisher. Do you want to read the damage? No, not really. Okay. Yes! We win! We're victorious. So what do we want to sideboard in? Well, he's got stuff like... He has a lot of creatures, actually. He has Finkel. He has... let's see, what else does he have? He's got Night Vale Spectre. He has Ink Eyes. He's got Frost Titan, Snapcaster Mage, Cryptic Command for counterspells, his Condescend for counterspells, so we're going to have to play our Burn a little bit differently, more carefully. It's Doomblade, so something like Elish Norn is kind of bad. I don't really want to play Mark of Mutiny. Let's look at the cards that are bad. I think everything so far is pretty sweet. So I'm just going to submit this as is.